Models, airline stewardesses,
the whole scene.
And all of them after just one thing.
My experience is most of them are after a large steak and french fries.
Your experience? Well, pardon me, pal, but that's your experience, isn't it?
Stanley, I'm going home.
Oh, come on, just stay for a while. Have one more beer. This may be your night.
Hey, Charlie. Excuse me. Charlie!
What happens after one more beer? We both get raped?
Oh. You're not joking. I'm telling you, this is the place.
Here, Charlie, do the same, huh?
Hello there.
How are you?
The fact is that you could get raped here and no one would know the difference. The subway with booze.
A paradise for bachelors.
You're serious, aren't you? You're really serious. You think all you have to do is stand there in your gold button blazer and your old teak aftershave lotion and... Right?
Right! I'm telling you, there isn't anything here you couldn't get with one small sherry.
Two Danish beers.
What's your change?
Oh, listen, thank you very much. Would you excuse me, please?
Hi. My name is Stanley.
I'm Fran.
Hi, Fran. How are you? Isn't this a groovy place?
Until now, I think it was kind of dull.
Oh, really? Then, haven't you got friends here or something? Fran, you got an apartment?
One room on 64th Street. I share it with my girlfriend.
She doesn't work nights, does she? Huh?
Whatever type of person made that movie must be sick in the head. 10 miles of traffic jams and human beings eating each other in the bushes? He must be sick.
Maybe we're sick. Does that occur to you?
No, it doesn't. Doesn't occur to me at all.
You blow your mind in traffic.
All right, so I blow my mind in traffic, but I don't eat my girlfriend.
I should be so lucky.
You know what I mean. I like a movie that has a beginning, a middle, and an end. And in that order so that you can follow it.
It's meant to be symbolic, Dean.
Pardon me?
I said it's meant to be symbolic.
Symbolic. That's right. That's exactly what it was meant to be.
I beg your pardon?
I saw that movie at the film festival. I thought it was totally symbolic of our materialistic aim.
Yeah, that's right. That's exactly what it was. I thank you
very
much.
Someone you know?
No, we just have more life to say. Can I buy you all a drink?
Yes, you can. I'll take a double Shivers Regal.
Right.
One double Shivers Regal, one vodka tonic, two dry French white wines. And a Michelob.
Can I help you?
Oh, right.
Isn't that your friend?
I'm glad you liked that movie.
I didn't.
Really?
Not much. Just didn't like him not liking it.
Oh, I see. What did you say your name was?
I didn't say. What's yours?
Ego Murphy.
Sleep well?
What there was of it. I didn't wake you, did I?
Oh, you didn't wake me.
You folded all my clothes.
Oh, you left them on the floor.
That's where I keep my things, mostly.
I slept great.
I noticed.
I feel great. Do you feel great?
Yeah, I feel fine.
Good God, 10 o'clock. Oh. Do you want anything before you go?
Like what?
Like a bath?
Sure, thanks.
Before you rush off.
Just like cats, sniffing around before they decide to bed down for the rest of their natural lives. The point is, has she found the spare room? A spare room gives them ideas. Gradual infiltration. This is the moment that calls for extreme caution. Extreme caution.
I suppose you haven't got time for breakfast.
Do you want me to make it?
What?
You want me?
No, I'll do it.
You've got a lot of room here. Is your wife away for the weekend?
I like a lot of room.
So you found the spare room.
Everything is so tidy. Our kitchen always looks like a battlefield. Maybe his wife left him.
Who do you live with? Husband? Boyfriend?
I hope you like your egg.
That's great. You want me to stay?
It's a farmer's egg.
Where do you get farmer's eggs?
I buy them.
From a farmer?
No, at a store. You can if you make a point of it. I mean, it's worth taking a little trouble.
Yeah, I guess so.
Chicken that laid that egg ate only what nature provided. It's organic.
That's a good thing. Must be some sort of health food nut. Myself, I just rush into the supermarket and buy prefabricated synthetic, any kind of stuff. Plastic eggs laid by computers, as far as I'm concerned. Cream and sugar.
egg's not what you usually have, is it?
Well, it all depends.
On who I wake up with.
It depends on who you wake up with.
Coffee's delicious.
Do you always jump into bed the first time you meet someone? In this country, the artificial hormones in the chicken food are having a disturbing effect on the adult male population.
No kidding.
I think I'll leave after breakfast.
Well, to tell you the truth, most of the time I don't have anything at all.
He's congratulating himself.
What did you say?
Nothing.
I played my cards very cleverly last night.
He is congratulating himself.
Birthday to you. It's not your birthday by any chance, is it?
Hi?
I said it's not your birthday by any chance.
Happy birthday to you.
Does that mean it is or it isn't?
What?
Your birthday.
Don't you know?
What do you mean? No, I don't read those things.
You don't?
No. No, I figure life's hard enough without worrying if my star got mixed up in the path of Leo and Tuesday would be a bad day to rob the Chase Manhattan Bank.
Yeah, I can see you're a Leo. You look like a Leo.
No, I'm Taurus. Taurus the bank robber. Listen, if you want to get back to your friends.
No, no, I'm fine.
Because I really didn't mean to interrupt anything. I was just.
No, we just went to the film.
I see. Is that what you do mostly?
People take me places when they feel I need educating.
You seem very intelligent.
No, I'm educated. Last week I went to the participating theater.
I'm sorry.
The participating theater.
What's that?
The audience is part of the show.
Everybody has to get into the act. What is it like?
Halfway through the show, they turn out the lights and you get groped by the actors.
Oh. Don't you resent that?
Not entirely.
Pardon me?
Not entirely.
Hey, look, we're going. Dean has an early class tomorrow.
Pity we didn't get a chance to see more of you.
Yeah, Dean's gonna drop me off. What about you?
Well, good night.
It would be no trouble for Dean at all.
It'd be a pleasure.
I think I might as well stay on a while longer.
I see.
Bye.
Bye.
Oh, wow, thank you.
Good night.
Good night. Good night.
I see. What did she say I see for? What did she see? When did you make up your mind? Exactly.
If you say you'll go listen to somebody's records, deals on.
Well, some girls wouldn't agree with you.
Haven't had many the first time, huh?
I wouldn't know about that.
Do you think you'd have appreciated me more if I'd cost you 3 dinners at Caravelle?
Girls are different, that's all.
You mean the nice ones take 3 weeks or so?
I suppose. 2 weeks on the average.
And how long do they last on the average?
Have some more coffee?
No, thank you.
I don't collect them, if that's what you're thinking. Like stamps.
Really?
I suppose you've had dozens.
Dozens of what?
Dozens of men.
Why did you say that?
It's just something a person likes to know.
Do they?
No, I mean, is it a girl or a woman could have had dozens of men and will still be okay.
That's very nice of you.
Very few, and still be.
A whore?
No, I wouldn't say that. I was just trying to get to know you.
Well, you haven't made a bad start.
No, I mean to know more about you. I mean, why did you?
Why did you?
That's different.
Is it?
Yes.
I just thought it might be fun, that's all. I thought I might enjoy it.
Did you?
I didn't see much to worry about, no.
You mean I've got you worried?
Yes, you have. All that talk about natural-born eggs tastes just the same as any old artificial eggs anywhere. And wanting to be told I'd jump into bed with anybody just so you wouldn't feel guilty when your wife gets home on Monday.
What are you talking about?
I suppose you think I go to that bar every Friday night, huh? Just to get laid? Well, I want you to know that I've never been in there in my life before. Just that Jane's boyfriend said, let's go somewhere slightly different. That's all. Sorry to disappoint you.
I'm not really disappointed.
There's something else you ought to get straight in your head.
What's that?
Just for the record. I do say no occasionally. Yeah, I'm fine, I guess.
Where are you?
Where am I? I don't know. Listen, I'm coming home now. I'll pick up the groceries. Eggs, so stuffed full of chemical hormones, there's a good chance we'll all change sex.
What?
Never mind. See you later. Bye.
Bonjour, darling. Up with the cornflakes. Hold it. Come aside, Papa.
Oh, for God's sake.
Bachelor girl home from a good night out with all her goodies. That's a great image. I tell you. Un grand amour.
On your own business.
This house is my business. I'm making a study of it in depth. Are you totally ignorant of cinema verite?
Cinema verite is just an excuse to follow little girls into the ladies' room. Do something with it.
See you in the morning.
Bye, baby. That's a great image. Oh, grand amour. Beautiful, beautiful. Beautiful.
Hello. You're not back.
No, I'm away.
I thought you were all settled for the weekend. Bob called to say he's coming up to Philadelphia tonight.
So the boss let him out to play.
That's not fair.
Doesn't anyone else care about these turtles?
It's not Bob's fault Mr. Beagleman wants to have him around all the time.
He doesn't have to marry the man, does he?
Mr. Beagleman is grooming Bob to take over the entire East Coast office. Next week he's loaning Bob's executive jet to fly to Florida.
No kidding.
Mm-hmm.
Do you get to go too?
Well, no.
Make Mr. Beagleman jealous?
He's not even going. Bob has to take this German client with a wife who might not understand.
It's too bad.
Anyway, he'll be here tonight. We had the greatest stroke of luck.
What's that?
Somebody died in a New York office. And, Mr. Beagleman sent Bob to represent him at the funeral.
Certainly gets picked for all the best jobs.
I wish you liked Bob.
I like him. I like him fine. I'd like him better if he took you out once in a while. Stop using this place as a hotel.
Yeah. He hasn't got his promotion yet.
I just got to hurry up and get it so I could have a bed for the night.
Jane's going over to Dean's. Please. Please.
All right.
Do you have to go now?
I have to go now. Excuse me.
Matter of fact, that was a good way of putting it.
Putting what?
I do say no occasionally. I like the way you said that.
Thank you.
As a matter of fact, I don't have one.
You don't have one? What?
A wife or anything resembling. I guess you jumped to that conclusion because of the size of the apartment. It's a converted attic. It was originally an artist studio.
You fix it up all by yourself?
Well, a friend helped. I'm still working on it. Hmm. Wait a minute. I almost forgot what we came for. To play a record.
Oh, a record.
We never did.
No, we never did.
It's not a bad collection. I usually play classical in the afternoon and jazz in the evening.
What do you play in the morning?
Brass band music. Provided, of course, it's not raining.
Well, let's not break any rules.
Extremely smart. Getting dressed, putting on her coat, setting out for the front door. Just the way to get asked back in again. I should have let her go on thinking I had a wife. She's at an advantage now, a distinct advantage. In the end, she'll have to go. Like Ruth.
I don't want to go to dinner with your groovy husband.
You won't. I don't have one. Is that going on the other side?
Right. I'll do it.
I never even thought about a husband.
Pardon me, miss.
Oh!
I am looking for a slightly used Amazonian blowgun. What's so funny about that? They're very difficult to get. I'll take it with or without darts.
My own frayed flower child.
You need all the flower children we can get these days. I mean, where else do you find people who are honest, intelligent, concerned, unprejudiced?
And on the pill.
And a smart ass.
How did you get away this time?
I volunteered to drive Stevie over to get his hair cut. I just gave him 50 cents to buy some candy.
You may never see him again. Should have given him a dollar.
I'll talk to you soon.
Hi, Dad.
Hello.
Yeah. Huh? Sir. The Amazon shipment should be in by Friday, sir. I'll keep your blowgun in mind.
You do that. Can I call you about lunchtime?
Yeah.
Good.
Why is she saying that?
Why is she saying that? Because I'm looking for something, that's why.
You tell us that if we work within the framework of the existing system, that we will get what we want. We work within that system, and we get token concessions to pacify us that do nothing for what we want. You are giving us tokenism. You are not giving us what we want. We want what we want now.
All right, let me tell you something. But the only way to get things done, to make them work outside of a protest on a campus, which does arouse us to what the problems are about, the way to get them done is through political means and through a political party that's responsive to you. And I'm saying you have a responsibility to do more than shout about what is wrong. That is great. You've done that. It's happened all over the world.
Black man has waited to go through the appropriate legislation or wait on your existing government, as you say. Where would we have been? Didn't we have to sit in? Didn't we have to stand in? Didn't we have to lay in?
Right.
Didn't we have to ride till city after city? Yeah.
Do you know what my stand is on Vietnam? Do you know what my stand is on the draft? Do you know what my stand is about the Black Revolution in this country? All right. If you know what it is, then you know that I do represent you, that my ideas of what to do up there in that so-called sacred hall come from you and from your responsiveness to me and my responsiveness to you. That's how a politician exists. Let me just say that it's been an exhilarating experience for me being here today. If there were this kind of energy and this kind of concern, deep concern, going on in the state Senate, we would have solved a lot of the problems of New York a long time ago. And let me also say that I know that many of you are disillusioned about what politicians, quote unquote, have made of this world, and you have a right to be. But you also have a tremendous responsibility to try to do something about it. And you have an opportunity to do something about it. You have an opportunity to define what American politics will be, to define what a politician is, and to have those politicians responsive to you and the kind of society you want. And in closing, as I have to do, let me just say that, in my opinion, you have coined the great motto of our time: make love, not war. Thank you.
About each other, do we? I mean, as far as we're concerned, we might be anybody.
I am anybody.
No, all I'm saying is that
I already know about you. I know that you cook breakfast and wash up your own dishes, and that you can't ask me to stay until you're quite sure I haven't asked to be asked to stay.
Is that all you know about me?
I know that I liked it with you.
Enough to do it again?
That's not an invitation, is it? That's a request for information.
I'll tell you anything you want to know.
Okay. Where do you live?
Here.
Where's here?
Here, the west side, Riverside Drive. Tell me about you.
Okay. What do you want to know?
What do you do? Exactly.
You mean work? Work. I work in a gallery at the moment.
Where exactly?
75th, near Madison. The Rasiga Gallery. I'm surrounded by primitive gods.
And where do you live?
On the east side, Murray Hill.
Where exactly?
Funky four-story walk-up. High ceilings. Trees on the street. We have a clock on the corner drugstore stopped around about 1930. I'm always late for everything. It's a very festive area. Young men with poodles live there. We get no more than one stab in a week. Downstairs, we have our own private movie director.
A director?
He's making a true life movie about our house.
Do you spend a lot of time with him?
Hours. He doesn't know half what goes on in the house. I have to tell him.
And you know everything?
I'm very inquisitive, haven't you noticed? On the second floor, there's these three Japanese boys. They're all brilliant. They do all their dating by computer. We spend a lot of time sewing on their buttons.
We?
Me and Hillary and Jane. You met them last night?
Oh, of course, the other two girls.
Right.
You're very close to those two, aren't you?
Oh, yeah. We tell each other everything, practically.
No, I told him, rub my stomach round and round and say, I love you, I love you. And oh, it's great. So then I said, lower, lower. And he said, I love you, I love you.
You know much about this music?
Not much.
George Frederick Handel. Very clean kind of music. It's all brass. No strings cluttering up the background. Very practical guy, Handel. I mean, give him a job like a trip up the river or a fireworks party. He just sat down and wrote music for him. This particular one was written for the King's fireworks. Pow! Did you hear that? Fireworks going up on the other side of the river. All those guys in powdered wigs just jumping out of their britches. Oh! Did you know that Handel wrote three oboe trios when he was 11 years old? I'm not kidding. I don't know what made me think of this, but you know, if you stand and suck a lemon in front of a brass band, the music stops. I mean it. Well, you try blowing a euphonium while someone is sucking a lemon in front of you. Can't be done. You'd be foaming at the mouth.
Sun's coming up.
She wasn't listening.
Now what have I done?
I was just presenting her with a little knowledge.
Actually, he was being a big brass band bull.
She surrounds herself with all these types.
It's hard work for something I don't really want, perhaps.
I wonder what she's thinking about. That movie director? One of her Japanese friends.
He's trying the oldest trick in the world. Just not trying. I'm not totally uneducated, you know.
I was boring you.
Didn't learn anything at school. Who does, for God's sake? But men teach me things.
I'm sure.
They explain all about the Electoral College and how to eat artichokes without getting your mouth full of leaves.
Did your director friend teach you that?
Everyone I know teaches me things.
Oh, but he taught you something.
Quite a lot.
Do you go to bed with him?
You're assuming rights on me.
Didn't you give me any?
No.
No?
No, what I gave you didn't have any rights attached to it. It was free. Do you think we have to pay for everything?
No, it's just that for a relationship to matter, I...
A relationship? Is that what we're having?
Two people should make... Well, I think the whole business isn't much unless they do make some sort of demands on each other.
I'm sorry. Are you sure I know enough about you?
What do you want to know?
What do you do?
Design furniture.
Did you design this by any chance?
Don't you like it?
Well, it could be more comfortable.
You didn't complain last night.
Why do you think I wanted to move to the bed?
It's meant to be functional.
Well, it worked, didn't it? Some snappy patter.
Hello?
Hi, it's me. I haven't seen you for months.
Oh. Hello, Ruth.
Who have you got there?
Oh, it's just a friend.
Listen, I'm having a party tonight, and I want you to come.
Tonight? I'm not sure about tonight.
Oh, come on. Try to make it.
Where is it?
It's at 414 East 55th Street, between Sutton and First.
Between Sutton and First? That's a pretty classy address. Are you, getting married or something? I forget when's your birthday.
It's not my birthday and I'm not pregnant. It'll just be good to see you, that's all.
Anyway, who knows how the day will end. Yes, I'll keep it in mind. I miss you too. I'm not sure whether she.
All right, I'll book that flight. Yes, it is lucky, darling. Right, I'll see you there. Thank you.
Elizabeth?
They're coming back a day early. They, want to meet me at the airport tomorrow morning.
Oh.
I'll have to put you on the plane tonight and catch the morning flight out.
I just thought of something.
What?
We can fly back together.
Hmm?
She has no idea what I look like, right?
No.
So we can both stay till tomorrow. We'll get off the plane and I'll be this perfect stranger. I can vanish.
Attention, please. Would you say Mr. Dealey, go this passenger of flight 107 from London? Please contact me. Attention, please. Will Mr. Dealey, passenger of flight 107 from London, please contact me.
I'll try to. Yes, I will. 753-2099. Right. Yes, I'll try.
Bye.
Bye.
I don't want any more to do with it. Not with jealousy, competition, the sound of bugles when we're all meant to line up for battle. When the bugle blows, I want to go home quietly. Lock the door, take off the telephone. Yeah, right. I'll wash my hair, watch a Saturday night movie, and go to bed with a plate of cornflakes. I can do that most efficiently. I can vanish.
Thank you. Hi.
Seem to have left my key. Oh, you probably fell out of my bag. Thank you. You expecting someone?
Yes. Oh. You.
No, I'm going home now.
Right, but you always leave something to come back for.
Who, me?
I mean, girls. Keys are the most popular.
Says the man of limitless experience.
Now, the problem is, what exactly are we going to give you for lunch?
You're going to make someone a wonderful wife.
Like to gamble on a cheese souffle?
Gamble on what you like. I'm not staying.
Perhaps you should ask yourself why you decided to go in the first place.
I suppose, after a lifetime's experience with women, you think our one ambition is to sit here all day listening to gems from Carnegie Hall and watch you demonstrate the art of cookery. Good grief, there's a whole world outside this little egg box you inhabit. And people who don't have to invent all sorts of complicated reasons for why they go in and out of the front door.
As a matter of fact, I know exactly why you left. You were jealous. Because I spoke to Ruth.
The lousy thing about him now is he's absolutely right.
There's a risk she'll just slam the door and clear out forever. Unless she has to know more about Ruth.
Who's Ruth?
Ruth? Just a girl I used to go with.
Used to?
It wasn't serious.
Was it?
Well, we knew each other for about 8 months, and sometimes she'd come over here and stay a while. And then, finally,
She moved out?
She moved in.
Anybody home? Darling, I've arrived.
So I see.
I'm moving in. Forever. Which way for the shrunken head? It's a groovy place you got here, baby.
Well, actually, it's not so large.
Should I put these in the bedroom?
You know, if you knock her up, I'll damn well sue you. I want her thin and upright for the spring collection.
Thanks, darling. Why should that happen now? I mean, we've been making it for months. I mean, I only moved in with him to save cab fare. Your clothes are going to get claustrophobic in this closet.
Well, who needs clothes?
Well, here, give me that.
Hey. Oh, shit.
Hey.
I'll get some glasses.
You know, I wonder about nuns. Do you suppose they'd make good models? At least you get none of these complications.
Hey, haven't you got any glasses? Hey, yeah. Oh, champagne!
Here's to it.
What?
Domestic life.
Is that what we're going to have?
Domestic life means another 2 inches on those hips. And who am I going to get to do the swimsuits in the Caribbean?
Mags, darling, what are you talking about? I'm going to work for him, aren't I? My hips to the bone.
No, honestly, I think...
Shut up, darling. Listen, when you come home from work, all tired and exhausted, you'll find your slippers by the fire and your evening meal defrosting on the stove. Because to hell with the equality of the sexes. I'm going to cook for you.
You're going to what?
One onion finely chopped. Half pound of hamburger meat.
Yes.
A half teaspoon of cayenne pepper. Half a teaspoon of more Worcestershire. Clove of garlic.
Hey, 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 that was the end of her.
So you're alone?
I was.
Yeah. What do you do with that now?
Put it in and hope for a miracle. Would you be so kind?
Oh, yeah. I could be so kind. Is this your main interest in life?
What?
Cooking?
It's just something I do on weekends, like tennis.
Play tennis?
Once in a while in the park. Keeps me fit.
I guess it would do that.
So, what are we going to have for a main course?
Wow, you've got so much food. How come?
Oh, I like to have a choice. It was the way I was brought up.
Your parents ran a restaurant?
No, my mother was a saint.
And where did that make you?
Hungry.
Why?
Oh, she was always out at meetings to prevent a Third World War, see? So she never got home before the stores closed. For many weeks, I lived entirely on weenies.
Ah. What did your dad say to that?
He died of starvation. No, not really. He was long gone. My mother had a group of friends from various causes, and I remember one of them used to say, Rosalie, that boy secretly jealous of our relationship, he's going through the usual Oedipus period. My mother's name was Rosalie. And to tell you the truth, I never wanted to go to bed with her at all. And I'm not really complaining about it.
No, of course not.
It's only when she sent my tennis shoes off in a bundle to the striking miners in Virginia, I wished them luck, but why the miners wanted a pair of size 7 junior tennis shoes, I couldn't figure out. A good woman. You're not good, are you? By any horrible chance?
Good? No, certainly not.
You didn't decide on the main course, madam.
Oh.
Grass-fed prime succulent steak, or the chef's dream of a butter-tossed golden free-swimming morning hook?
That'd be fine.
All right.
We can have the fish tonight.
Wrong.
Moving in. More subtle than Ruth, naturally. More gentle, but still moving in.
We can eat the fish this evening. That's what you say when you've been married for years.
She said, as if we've been married for years.
Am I out of my head, involving myself with a character who plays tennis? What kind of a future's in that? Be here tonight.
Oh, that's right. Much better. Take her out somewhere and then, well, if it doesn't work out, I can drop her at her place.
Anyway, I might even be busy tonight.
I thought we might go out somewhere, possibly.
Possibly.
Get some fresh air, see how you look in front of trees. I got asked to a party later on, but you might not want to go.
No, I might not.
Kind of a wide-open invitation.
I hate parties. Can't help it. I'm not cut out for it. The mind wanders. I always want to vanish from parties.
Hey.
Good morning.
How long have you been here?
Went to a party last night.
You should be more careful. I sometimes drive the kids to school.
Yeah, well, you ought to leave your car locked then. The party was dreadful. But I met this nice boy, and we sneaked off to the kids' playroom, played ping pong, drew pictures. It was really fun. Some lady kept shouting upstairs, "What's going on up there, children? Will you please go to bed?" Actually, we didn't.
Really?
Finally, he said he'd take me home.
Your home?
Not exactly, no. But, on the way, we passed by your car, and I said, "Leave me here if you value your life. My husband is insanely jealous. And what's more, he's a crack clay pigeon shot."
I was your husband.
Last night you were. When he heard that, he dropped me off like I had the plague or something. Then I just sort of got in here and sat. It was a beautiful sunrise. I wish you'd seen it. Then I guess I fell asleep. What are you gonna do now?
I think I'll buy you kippers at the Plaza Hotel.
Kippers! Perfect!
Hey.
Just what I got in here for.
Careful, you nut. I've got to talk to Elizabeth. I mean, for God's sake, everybody gets divorced these days.
I don't like to think about that.
At least I could give you a home.
One could live quite comfortably in a Mercedes.
I don't know what you want. I don't know what you're looking for.
Breakfast at the Plaza Hotel.
Success.
Brilliant.
Let's see.
Yeah.
The great thing is, if men can cook at all, women think it's wonderful.
Well, it is.
No, it's really a legend. Like sex and black men.
Of course, you know all about it.
What do you mean?
I guess you're a practically perfect person.
It's hot.
I mean, you know all about brass bands and... Mm-hmm. Cooking, God knows, and theory of sex in a multiracial society.
Yes. No. You know, I really don't know all that about the theory of sex. You know those books you read as a kid?
Yeah.
300 Ways to a Sexually Fulfilled Marriage?
Yeah.
The diagrams confused me.
Yeah, diagrams are confusing.
I suppose you started with practical experience.
Well... As a matter of fact, he was a Boy Scout.
A what?
You don't want to hear this.
Tell me.
No, it's not a story I usually tell until much later.
Later?
Yeah, I get to know someone really well.
And you haven't,
No, of course not.
But go on.
Well, I was a Girl Scout.
A brownie?
No, about to be full-fledged Girl Scout. Had a natural talent for knots.
How old were you, exactly?
16. His camp was in the next field. One night, all the other girls were going to the movies. I was being punished, so they left me behind to do the dishes.
I'm going.
Wait, wait.
It was much better than I read about.
Hurry up!
Did you do it again?
We went home the next week. Summer was over, didn't get another chance.
I mean, anywhere else?
No. He lives someplace in Philadelphia. I never saw him again. He had sort of pink eyes, brown hair. It's funny, I don't usually feel this way after lunch.
It's the best time to feel this way. Evenings for going out and talking to your friends and meeting people, going to the movies.
Yeah.
Afternoon's just perfect. After a great lunch like that, plenty of wine. There's only one thing I want to do.
Join the Diet Tipple set.
The night his boss came to dinner, she served gourmet salt, the condiment of continental...
It's raining. Guess there's not much point in going out.
What time is it?
I'm gonna go.
Well, what time is it?
1 o'clock. I fell asleep.
You never noticed my new nightgown?
Of course I did.
We never have the whole night together, so I thought you ought to see me in a nightgown.
Mm-hmm.
Does it occur to you?
Hmm?
I was just wondering if it ever occurred to you that just because of you, anyone would be willing to put up with dinner once a week with their nightgown in a brown paper bag. Only to be abandoned at 1 a.m. with nothing to do but read the hotel shopping guide. Don't you think that's very flattering, huh? Don't you think that's very flattering?
I do.
You don't. You think it's perfectly natural.
Yeah.
Wish you didn't have to go.
I'm sorry.
Not complaining.
One day, you'll find a perfectly good husband with a Mustang and an English tutor in Scarsdale, and you'll spend perfectly happy evenings together playing Monopoly. I'll come to the wedding.
Oh, no, you won't.
All right. I'll tell you what I'll do. I'll wait until you call, and I'll meet you when you come to buy the living room drapes at Bloomingdale's.
Yeah, then we'll have lunch downstairs, and we'll come up here till it's time to get dressed and go out and buy lamb chops for his dinner.
I'd like that.
No way.
Why not?
Because if that time ever came, I'd have to say goodbye to you, wouldn't I?
Now you'd need me even more.
Add a little color to my life.
At least once a month. You haven't met anyone, have you?
With a house in Scarsdale. No, not yet.
Good night, darling.
Don't go away.
I'm here.
Hi.
Hi.
What time is it? Oh, wow, it can't be. Why didn't you wake me up?
Well, you were having such a good sleep.
Are we still going out?
You didn't really want to go out, did you?
No, you did that, didn't you?
Not really.
Were you here the whole time?
I washed the dishes.
Oh, I was gonna do that.
No, it doesn't matter.
I don't know. I just couldn't stay awake. How long were you here?
Well, about an hour.
When I was dreaming, too?
About me? Someone nice?
No, nobody nice at all. What happens now?
You stay where you are.
Oh, no. It's good, isn't it? Nobody's in a hurry to get dressed, be home before anyone realizes they're gone. It's so ordinary. It's unusual.
At least until Monday.
It's good.
Although I suppose we'd have to eat.
Not till Monday.
It makes me hungry.
I'll cook for you. I'll cook you some weenies.
Thanks a lot. I don't want you to ever get out of this bed.
What a day it's been, huh? We haven't really done anything. Nothing at all. Phone call.
What?
I've got to make a phone call.
No, come on. Well, you have to call some guy?
No, just Hillary. I called her this morning and told her I'd be back with the groceries. She'll be expecting me.
Stay where you are.
No, we'll see. Her boyfriend might be in town. I've got to tell her the coast is clear.
You always operate this way?
Well, if we don't synchronize our plans, then one of us has to stay in the kitchen the whole time reading.
Yeah, can't she arrange her own life?
Sure she can. Just needs a little help occasionally.
She had to fill the place with other people.
I've got to make a phone call.
It was going fine.
Listen, her boyfriend might be back. I have to tell her the coast is clear.
Just when we decided, we made up our minds.
She just needs a little help occasionally.
And everyone else, every needy stranger.
It's rotten, I know.
He knows how I look forward to seeing
Listen. Pour yourself a big glass of whiskey. and take a hot bath or something.
Oh, huh? Good, that'll do.
And if you get desperate or you just want to talk or anything, call me. Anytime. We'll be here all the time.
What's your number?
Oh, I'm at 744-9970. Got that?
Yeah.
Okay. Bye.
Was that your friend, Hilda?
Yeah. Her boyfriend got his secretary to call and give her the brush off. Hmm.
Sounds as if she could be lucky.
She doesn't see it that way. It's her we've got to worry about.
Why?
Hmm?
Why do we have to worry about her? She, taking it badly?
Yeah, she does take these things badly.
I suppose she wants you to run home and hold her hand.
I suppose she would like that.
Why don't you? Isn't she your best friend?
Of course, that's why she understands.
What?
That it's all right for me to stay here with you.
My needs greater than hers.
I knew what I was doing.
Well, you really have to spread yourself around, though. Did you ever pick it against the war?
What are you talking about?
Did you ever collect money for Biafra? Huh?
Yeah, so what?
How do you find time to do all that between sewing buttons on for the Japanese and helping the film director downstairs and seeing your girlfriends through all their crises?
Well, it keeps me pretty busy.
And getting me through a bad bout of sexual starvation. I think you better go. I said I think you better go.
Yeah, heard you the first time.
Poor Hillary needs you much more than I do.
Oh, I don't think so.
How do you know?
I know I'm not wrong about Hillary.
It's not easy.
Sorry.
What?
I'm sorry it's so difficult for you. Want me to go and see Hillary and then not come back anymore? Is that what you want?
I don't know. Things aren't right.
Because I called her?
No. I don't think it will work.
Give it a chance.
No, I know it wouldn't work. That's what I'm trying to tell you. It's just that if it's going to be serious, it better be right.
Funny thing is, I thought it was. What's my coat?
Oh, it's the right one.
Yeah, it's the right one.
Shall I get you a cab?
It's all right, I'll find one.
with our chemical reactions.
I know.
What are we supposed to do all day Sunday to keep our minds off sex?
In school, in convent school, they proposed a fast game of volleyball.
And does that work?
It makes you horny as hell.
You picked a bastard, too.
No, not really.
How can you say that after the way he treated you?
Could have been worse.
How?
Could have waited till tomorrow and then politely lost me. Could have done that. Could have dropped me off and then said, I'll call you in a week. At least he didn't try to make it easy.
Nose flute, don't you?
Not at all.
Bloody nose flute or shirt, if ever I saw one.
Hi, baby.
Ruth? Apparently, there were these three nuns who went into a whorehouse and...
Hi.
Darling, this is Charlie. You're lovely. He tells jokes.
We've met.
Apparently, there were these three nuns who went into a whorehouse in San Francisco to shelter from the rain. And the...
Where's your friend?
She left.
They all have to go, don't they, love?
What do you mean?
I mean, just as soon as they actually sit on the chairs or spill ashes down the john, they leave wet footprints on the bathroom floor. I mean, you don't actually want living people around there, do you?
Well, that's,
not for any length of time.
Not altogether true.
What was she like?
I don't really know. Oh. I'll be right back.
Oh, wait a minute. Hey, wait, I want my money now, hey. Hey, buddy!
Stan.
Well, did you get laid?
Have you seen her?
What, that broad you left with last night? No, I didn't see her. Hey, give my friend a beer, will you?
I don't even know her name.
Oh, listen, man, you got lucky. Be thankful. You know what happened to me? I put in an hour's charm and witty conversation to find out that this neurotic wreck that I was with had the curse.
I must be out of my mind. I didn't even ask her name.
Yeah? Well, you know what's in the back of their mind sometimes? I'll tell you. It's not good, clean sex they're after, you know. It's a weird, perverted trip to City Hall.
I have to find her.
Wait a minute. Will you have your beer? Relax. She'll be around. Come on.
What do you mean?
Oh, for God's sake.
What are you talking about?
Look, she's got another two nights hunting before she turns up all pale and interesting in the office Monday morning.
You idiot.
What's the matter
You're
with you,
idiot.
Man? Hey, man, what...
You don't call me, man.
Hey, what...
Murray Hill. She said the Murray Hill area.
That's where we are, Chief. Any particular street you got in mind?
Turn here, right here. This must be it. There's trees on the street. Now all we need is a clock that stopped in 1930.
Oh, I get it. This is one of those television shows.
Officer, I'm looking for a street with trees. It's a very respectable area, only one or two stabbings a week.
Do you,
No, you don't understand, right?
Sir, pardon me. Do you live around here?
Why, yes, I live at the...
You know an apartment with three girls in it?
Girls?
Yeah, three.
Oh,
man. I'm sorry.
Let's face it, buddy. You don't know where the hell you want to go. Let's go home, huh? Home?
Yeah, I guess you're right.
All right, so where's home?
52 Riverside Drive.
52 Riverside Drive, okay.
Dinner's not ready yet.
Huh?
Didn't expect you back so soon.
I was looking for you.
I know.
You didn't go.
I came in here and I sat down and I thought we might as well have the fish.
I tried to find you. I tried.
Running away from each other won't work anymore, will it?
Tomorrow we'll go and get your clothes.
You. Tomorrow we can do that. Do you want the fish now, or we could wait till later?
We'll wait. I never got your name.
Oh, it's Mary.
Mary?
Uh-huh.
Really?
Yeah. Yours?
John.
John?
John. Mary.
Yeah.
Mary.
John.
Mary.
John.
How do you spell?
M-U-R-R-Y.